Welcome to the stream. If you're watching later on YouTube, as always, thanks for clicking. Hope you're enjoying. Yeah, I'm here now, so. You know what? This area is not that big. But hopefully my cold resist is enough, so. Okay. I'm rested up, so. I don't remember if there's anything here. I think this is just a pit at the. I get the feeling that in Tears of the Kingdom we're gonna be able to follow this down. I would bet that one of the scenes where it shows Link going down this cavern of sorts, it's probably here. I think a lot of these either ancient ruins or something like this are going to serve as entries to new areas. I probably shouldn't have come down here. It's alright. Yeah, this was not a good idea. That works. That did not work. That did less than what I would have liked. I thought, oh yeah, no, that'll take out both of them. Nope. Not even close. I need a smart way to do this. I do need to check out the area, it's just. Ignoring that. Because we don't want to enter the Gerudo area. I'm just going to do the coverage around here. because there's bound to be something down there. May have been a mistake. It looks like it's just a camp. What? It feels like stalking to watch intently without saying anything. Like you're watching me. I mean, a lot of people do that. It's just, I'm sure there are people that have been watching me for years and have never said a word, so I don't know. I don't know how to say something without being like, oh shit, that's weird. But it's not weird. Oh. Crap, what is this? Oh, it's cold? Really? Okay, that's better. They have a lot of stalkers. I mean, lurkers, yeah, stalkers, hope not. that's not a good one. This is largely disappointing. I mean, it just depends on the person. Some people just want to watch. And are just entertained by that. Others want to interact. Others wait a while before they interact. Okay, well that's obviously a Korok. There's also a category of people that won't talk unless other people are talking, which does happen. I mean, this is, I think this is still on the same tower. How much meat? 261. Okay. That's how many times I've been interrupted by wolves, give or take. Hello, new chat member. I don't know how to say your name, but welcome. Yeah, I'm in a bit of a mind haze today, as I've slept a lot. Hmm. If you're new to a stream, you don't talk in a quiet chance unless you have a question. That's fair enough. I think that's why there's a bunch of streamers that just want people to chat no matter what, and it's pretty much for that reason. Oh crap. Why are Australian people so chill? I mean, we have our issues, but I think it's just, it's something that's in the Aussie culture. It's just a term you hear very often is, nah, she'll be right, which is just effectively Hakuna Matata. The Australian we have Hakuna Matata. That's the easiest way to explain it. We have Hakuna Matata as part of our, like, ethos. It's just, that's who we are. That is not to say that you can't get an Aussie that's, that gets angry easily. It does happen. Where is this rock? It's just in general here, you get the whole, you know, ah, life's too short to worry about that shit. Just, ah, there it is. Aren't we required to vote? Yeah, we have to vote. Is that, like, correlation to why we're so chill, or just a separate question? Yeah, because, at least, you know, on voting day, we do this tradition thing where when you go to vote, they have a sausage sizzle, which is just, you know, it's a barbecue, think of it that way. And you just get what's known as a democracy sausage. It's just a barbecued sausage in white bread, and then you get ketchup or grilled onions on top if you want. And you get one of those when you go vote. So, it's not, it's one of those things that it's just so ingrained into culture here that it's an expectation that when you go vote that that's made available to you. And it's considered un-Australian if it's not. You say it because you saw another Australian stream and people were so nice and so chill. Yeah, I mean, I guess that's why I like it here. It's just, in general, people are decent. It's not to say, you know, we're saints or anything, right? Like, we have our issues as well, but in general, you know, Aussies are pretty easy to get along with, and, we're kind of everywhere. There's this joke where no matter where you go in the world, you'll run into an Australian at some point. Because we're always on holiday. I think that's the premise to the song Land Down Under. Can I describe a barbecue? It's a grill. Just think of it as an outdoor grill. That's all it is. It's just a cookout. What else? I don't know how else I've heard Americans describe it. I'm not going to address the Paul Hoganism in the chat. We will ignore the Paul Hoganism. The Crocodile Dundee. You're not American. That's fair enough. I just, usually when I get that question, that's, I tend to assume that it's because I'm saying something that doesn't quite translate to how Americans say it. But it's just cooking outdoors on a grill. That's all it is. Yeah, it's just a meal cooked over a flame outside for us. I don't know. I've tried to get used to saying alternate ways of certain terminology and words, but sometimes it's hard. It's hard to know. Didn't I hear it go off a second ago, or is it? I'm trying to do this pretty systematically. I get the feeling that one's in the ravine there. Oh, I think I know where this one is. On one of these things. Oh, around here you call it asado. Okay, well, I'm familiar with that. Whilst I live in Australia, my family is Salvadorian, so there you go. No, yeah, Central American barbecues go off. And I'm gonna call that a barbecue, but you know what I mean. That's Christmas for us. You've never tried Aussie barbecue? There's no such thing, really. It's... because the way it works here, there's just so many people that have immigrated here that a lot of places... there's just heavy influences from different countries, so there's not a whole lot of food that you would say is just purely Australian. But you get a mix of everything. It's like here where I live, in Melbourne. You just name a country and you can pretty much find food from it, and... yeah. I'll give you an example, like, sausages, right? You can have your traditional just beef or pork ones. But then they also do ones where it's, like, say, Asian influence. Like, they might have, like, spices that they use in Thai cooking, right? So they have that sort of flavor to them. Or you might be able to get ones that are more, like, Middle Eastern. Can also get ones that, you know, just association with Central America and all that, like, they just give them that association. But yeah, that's what it is here. It's just, you can get whatever. Is it normal to cook seafood and barbecue? Just prawns. More often than not, I think they just serve fresh, like, you know, lightly cooked, and then you just peel them and eat them. And they just sit there on ice. That's been my experience, primarily. Where on earth... am I going crazy? I swear I heard it go off. Hmm. I mean, my experience with, you know, family events is it's more Central American and South American, because got family members who are both from El Salvador and Peru, and then, you know, they invite other people, like Colombians and who else? I'm trying to think. Venezuelans. I'm going through the list of my head. But these things, sometimes there's just things that are just typical at an Australian one. I don't know. It's really nothing different. It's just what we're calling it. It might seem weird. Okay, I'm giving up on this one. I don't hear it again. There are 5 Koroks in the valley below. Yeah, I think as long as it's clear that... That's so weird for them not to include this part here in the map. Anyway, it's fine. I'll just leave it. I'm gonna be back there anyway. Gotta go, have a good one. Alright, no worries. Thanks for popping in. See ya. Hang on. I'm opening my water bottle. Yeah, because this is the pathway into Yiga territory. So, there's a lot here. It's just weird that it didn't go off again. That was pretty much in the same area. Maybe I'm just hearing them. That can happen. The brain is a weird one. Like, the studies that show that there are people that can experience this sensation of a phantom phone vibration. So they feel like their phone's gone off in their pocket, but it actually hasn't. And it's just one of those things that just stems from some weird anxiety. So, it could be that I'm just hearing Koroks and nothing's really happening. Now, the other night when I wrapped up, I was definitely caught up in thought about whether or not I want to try and do everything on 3 hearts or not. Or just stick to the plan. I was thinking of the foods I would make to try and get through some of the stuff, like visualizing it. What? I heard another one go off here. Where is it? Or is this just another valley one and I'm just being... I should just stay away from that edge. I think I should just stay away from that edge. It's tricking me into thinking that there's one up here. I find it interesting that there are people that don't have that sort of imagination as well. Like, there are people that claim they don't dream. Like, maybe they don't remember it, but I don't know. Is so large, and I'm guessing all the ones intended for this area are here, because this just seems very largely empty so far. I'm really not looking forward to exploring the desert. It's just this large wasteland. You unfortunately have near complete memories of your dreams. I can see how that could be bad, especially if they're not good dreams. I mean, it depends. It's just, sometimes it's pretty crystal clear, other times it's just a bit of a haze. Why did one of them run away and the other one is insistent on fighting? Gotcha. I don't know if I should bother here. Feels like that pathway is just enemies and nothing else. It'd be unlikely to have anything other than that. Wait, what? You have dreams where you'll be in school going through 10 different bathrooms with like 100 non-private toilets in each, and then each toilet will be disgusting. And when you finally find an acceptable one, you'll wake yourself up because you know peeing in dreams is risky business. Man. That's a hell of a conundrum. It's like, the anxiety of finding a stall and then just going, wait a minute, I shouldn't. I mean, that's some semblance of lucidity if you're like going, no, you know what, no. I'm doing very shitty coloring in of this area. So hang on, how many am I up to? Yeah, there had better be at least 70 in this area. Which is okay. I mean, if it's one that, okay. I see what it's pointing out. Wait, your dreams have continuity? If that's... I don't think that's very common, that dream continuity. Wait, this is colder? Okay, it's fine. Does this really put a whole apple in each one? Imagine not having 5 apples. Okay, that's that. That's that. And that. Huh. So it wasn't this. That's the Korok. What about here? I mean, it's still going off here. Or is it banana? I do remember that H1 had an intricacy to it. This area seemed to like bananas. That's what I remember. Bananas. I'm guessing the first one probably hints that it's bananas. So... just... drop down normally. Oh, they just keep bouncing off. Wait, there's no straightforward hint. Then how do I know that these are bananas? I mean, at some point I would have figured it out, it's just how. You know, at this point, I may as well go back down. Because there's a million bananas in the base. I guess that's the reason, but... would it make you think to try bananas? Because the majority of them are apple. I mean, hey, I'm happy about this. The closer I get to 800 in this area, the happier I'll be. That arrow is really not representative of what it's about to do. La ha 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 ha. Okay. 771. There should be one more. You sold all your peppers just to immediately find one Korok that requires a pepper. Don't sell your peppers. Well, I guess for me, they're super important. Because they're like the foundation of my cold resist. Very Korok rich area. Also one that I'm not planning to climb up normally because I see the rocks. I see all the boulders. I see them. You don't eat anything other than one cooked turnip or one cooked enjoy shroom. Right. Gotcha. No, you gotta play different if you're doing this. I think that's the one I saw. You might start doing attack up elixirs. Defense, don't underestimate defense up as well. Like, defense up is pretty sick. It gives you quite a bunch of effective health. But yeah, attack up is also very decent. If you're ever gonna do Trial of the Sword, like I said, defense up is the way to go. Get one a buff that lasts half an hour, and then you rely on a flaming weapon to keep you warm. Wait, where'd it go? Oh, no, it is there. Shit. Okay, I'm safe. Ay, ay, ay. Alright. Did it reset? I can't tell. Hold on. Ugh. I should have used the stamina thing. I thought I had enough to get up, but nope. Alright. Did it reappear? Can't see it. I think I have to restart it. Oh no. Okay, I guess I got it. Hey, Sandy. There was another one I heard here, but I think it was more this way. Okay. Wait for it. I forgot to charge my controller yesterday, so I'm all wired in. I slept really well. Just bit of a bad sleep pattern, perhaps. Did I get a water flosser? No. Still, no. I mean, maybe when I do tax this year. You're disappointed. Why? Do I have to buy everything that chat mentions? Is that not how it works? That what? You lead me to financial irresponsibility? But isn't... It's not really financial irresponsibility if you're telling me to get something that is potentially beneficial for my hygiene and health. Like, I wouldn't exactly call that responsible. Irresponsible, I should say. Now, if you were saying, hey, you should totally get a cannon that fires t-shirts, despite not producing t-shirts, it's just, I think the idea of owning a t-shirt cannon is cool. Like, if it was stuff like that, sure, that's financially irresponsible. Can you own one in Australia? I don't think so, no. Not sure. To be honest, I think pneumatic ones are okay. But I'm not 100% certain, as I've never really seen them before. But I would imagine it's possible that it's not allowed. I don't know. It's almost like if this was a podcast, I'd turn to the person relegated to looking shit up on the internet. I'd be like, yo, look that up. Instead, I'm typing with one hand. Apparently, there are t-shirt launchers you can rent, so... I think... companies are allowed to rent them. I'm not sure if personal ownership is okay. It seems to be okay. There's a lot of places that do a hire of it. Which I, because it looks like it works off the same way a tennis ball launcher works. So. Oh, it's hot. It's the opposite now. There we go. Yeah, I think they're perfectly fine. Oh, right. Yeah, this annoying shit. I forgot about this. The beast ruins your radar. So, like, finding Koroks in the desert area is, yeah. It's kind of an annoying endeavor, but that's okay. I don't need to do too much of it. I would imagine you might have to get, I think it's a case of you might have to get permission to use it in a public space from your local council. I would imagine it's something like that, as opposed to it being just a restriction on usage / purchase. I think it's a case of it's more of a you need to get permission to use one because public liability. Yeah, I think it's a standard safety regulation. And it's more a case of the council / building owner if it was at a venue. Would be my guess. People can get injured. It's happened. Whether from the projectile hitting or just a result of trying to get said projectile, it can cause accidents. Isn't that how Ned's wife dies in The Simpsons? that she gets hit by a t-shirt cannon or something. And she falls off the grandstand. Okay, I need to swap back to... this temperature balance thing. Wait, you had a guy in the States die by trying to catch a home run ball but ended up flipping over the railing. Yeah, shit. That stuff does happen. It's a freak accident. This is why you just shouldn't play sports. It's just, it's safer. Or don't, even still, don't be a fan of sports. Being a fan of video games is a much safer experience. I don't think I should go any further. Because I think that that right there is the, I'll stop at a certain point. But we're approaching the entryway. It is very eerie just being watched by all these frogs. And this is as far as I go. The moment they start appearing, it's just not worth me going in this direction anymore. I mean, it's just one of those things that you just never know when your time's up. Could be perfectly fine and then just something random happens. That's why just the whole trying to do things without letting certain things live rent-free. It's just life's too short. can't believe how dumb this one is. Wait, you had a dude jump off a ski lift during summer and fell over 40 feet, and then he tried to fight you. What? Tried to fight you for trying to help. Man. He was inebriated. Yeah, I kind of gathered. You'd have to be in a bad state of mind. Shodanto. Two bombs. Yep. I was weird that that floated up like that. Why didn't that work? There we go. Weird. I mean, that's one thing this game does well. Making you feel smart. Why is it being weird? Okay, it doesn't matter. Good enough. Did it really not let me go through? Where did Crate go? Crate died, right? I mean, you can hypothetically get over. This is just me trying to be a vandal here and get across this. The crate lived. It did, but I don't want to waste that many octo balloons. I don't think I can get any higher. I thought for sure I could squeeze in that gap, but I think what I needed to do... Hang on, let me load it. I have a plan. It's a very delicate operation. Happening. How did I blow it up without blowing up the one crate before? How did that happen? Okay, hang on. I just want to be creative. Like, I understand how this one works. For the record. I'm just trying to do something creative. I guess it's gonna be lodged that way, huh? Oh, see, I could get up here, no problem. So it's not the issue, it's more the final aspect of it, which I think I know what to do. That's 5 this time. Oh, shit. I think it hits this invisible ceiling. Trying to do this the funny way, but it just doesn't work. There's an invisible wall that it hits ultimately at the top that prevents it from doing its thing. Okay. I was crouching. I thought it was like a simultaneous thing. Talk about overcomplication. Says first. Yeah, it's the same thing. So why didn't that work? Okay. It would have been good if I could have floated up there, but eh. What the fuck? Huh? Did I just... So that jump that I just did, that wasn't normal, right? Like, that was... clearly not a normal jump. How did I do that? Almost did it again. Nearly.
Huck.
think I'm overcomplicating this one way too much. But it's kind of fun to do so. Holy shit. Okay. There we go. I'll just be patient. There we go. Yeah, that went well. The word resourcefulness in this case, I wouldn't say that. That's definitely one. Oh, jeez. Surprise electric case. That thing just... Did it hit my bomb? I think it did. Okay. Yah, ha, 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 ha. 775. Oh, it's an error. I'll be happy if I can get anywhere close to 800 today. Okay, I can't go any further down because that's just... Oh, no, wait, no. Okay, mistaken. Yeah, I'm not exactly sure how I'm gonna go with finding Koroks in the desert. It's one of those things that it's just, I can go roam and find them, but you know, I'm obviously gonna be lost because of the sandstorm, so it's like, yeah, I have choices to make. How am I missing that? There we go. Seven, six. Just climb. I'll deal with stamina. Let's go one level higher. Surprised it's Farosh up here and not Nadra. I do find it weird. You would think Nadra would be in all the icy areas. Almost feels like there should be a Korok there. Okay, well I know that the top here is not going to have anything because that's just the dome to the arena. Yeah. Spot in particular sucks because I just don't know if I should go explore it or not. Wow, this wolf. Dodging all my bombs. Like, I know further down it's not the case, but here. This might be different. Elevator. That might be bad news. Is that thing trying to throw rocks at me? Okay, hang on. Oh, jeez. What? There's nothing here as well. I don't know if I want to drop down onto that. Just seems like a long way to have to climb back up. I think the spot specifically... I know one of these is specifically where the Divine Beast is gonna sit. It might be here, even. Snow time. Still weirded out by that rock. Like, why is that there? Doesn't get it out of the way though. I don't think this is worth it. I mean, okay. Treasure chests. There was like an angle where I could see it. There we go. Damn, a bunch of Gerudo stuff in here. That's a nice bow. Just saying, what's the best here? It's a 16er. Time to climb. Probably the best spot to get up. Yeah. Okay. And so it begins. Hopefully I have enough to get through all of this. Really? Why are you here? I can't believe that thing followed me here. Shit. Damn it. Okay, at least this is reliably somehow something I can stand on. fine. I gotta be careful though, because this is a snowball, I think. Holy shit, what happened there? Oh god, that's what happened. And the game, of course, deciding to spawn something directly behind me as I'm trying to achieve something. Just classic. Classic style spawn. Ah, that's annoying. Wow, that's irritating. It really couldn't have done what it does usually, where it just puts me back where I was. Was that too hard? Apparently that was too much for it. And that is save next time. I got the same Octorok again. The same Octorok chased me. Gonna save because otherwise it's gonna put me back where I was, and I don't want that. Yeah, I'm walking this one across. Okay, that shouldn't go over, hopefully. Wanker. Okay, I got a load. Good thing I saved. There's a dip in there that's causing it to go around. Like, it's by design that it's doing that shit. I'm just gonna walk it up. It's not worth risking. Seven, seven, seven. That is, that's the Talus. Would be nice if I could mark it. Ah. Well. That's for real. Yeah, running's a lot tougher in this area. I forgot to purchase the Rita armor. Not that it would matter, but just thinking about it. Because I wouldn't be wearing it. It's just more... Yeah, I should have bought it. Off right when I'm about to do something every time. But I got the feeling there's nothing up here. They wave high and then I just assassinate them. It's kind of funny. Sophia's table. I think that big thing over there is the shrine. I mistimed the traction in the snow. It makes it slower to move across, so. Okay, good. Oh no. Loading. That's an interesting spot to autosave. Thank you. really. The game needs to cut four. No, three. Still three. It just needs to calm down with these enemies. I think it's leaving. Okay, I see one. I have to drop down. I love how it's got away from that one, and now here I am again. Okay, it's over there. Ugh. I'm saving just in case this could go wrong. Seven, eight. I was half expecting there to be something else, but there wasn't. Alright, back up we go. What? That was weird. I just didn't want to get out of the ground. Yeah, I'm just gonna ignore it, it's fine. These ones are easier to manage because they just... they stop and they start spitting ice and that lets you get away from them. So, they're easier. Unlike the other ones where just artillery shot. There's that whole thing as well. Safe. Oh, what is that? It's just treasure chests. Are we good? Nope, another one. Okay. Weren't quite done yet with the enemies attacking. Resist has got me. Fling it. There we go. Let it go. It's down there. I don't think this was worth it. ₹100, sure. Eventually, we'll go down that path, just not yet. That is a Korok. I mean, this is nice because it lets me make more cold resist food here. Just here. It sounded like a bear. Might not have been. Careful there. Oh shit, it's a bear. Wait, you can't, the bear is immune. The bear is immune to stop time. It's a warning shot, bear. Wow, it hasn't given up yet. You should have left. Yep. Holy crap, how many hits does Bear want to take? About time. That's all the meat you get from a bear. For all those hits, that's all I got. I guess. It would have made a sound if it was a Korok, so. I was just paranoid it was going to be like the stick thing. This is great. Okay. 7 7 9. I mean, it's nice that it's stocking me up on fire arrows. I can appreciate that. I'm just gonna do a lap around it, just so it's all marked out. Even though I don't think there's anything else up here, but it's for good measure. Uh-oh. Right, I almost walked into the fake. It's a pretty decent sword, but yeah, I mean, we're good. Going back. Whoops. Too much of a fall. I thought I was fine to go shield surfing there. That was an unnecessary death. Aww, game. Why? Just a sword. I don't know, it's just a sword. It's fine. This is what I was trying to do. Okay. Oops. Yeah. 780. Now I need to climb back up. It's the only downside of this one. Yeah. Let's just move away from here.
The blood moon rises once again. Please be careful.
Hopefully this thing will give up in a minute. There's nothing here. There's also the matter of, well, all this. Ugh, man. I'm starting from the high ground and then I'll do the sweeps around the low ground. This was more of a just so it's registered that I've been here as opposed to finishing it. I think the thing that I need to shoot with an arrow is nearby. I probably should have marked it from a distance where it was. It's visible from here, I believe. Or like, yeah, it's like on that side. I dropped her to see. If it was nearby, it doesn't look like it. I mean, on the shelf nearby. At this point, it was easier just to come back this way. Oh. Yeah, but if I go down there, it's just a pain in the ass to come back up. I'm gonna do that. I feel like that one's important enough to point out. No, shit. Oh my god. Link! What is that? Falling. Oh, that's where I got up originally. Okay, I see where I am. Which means there's a Lionel over there.
I know.
And the Talus. I mean, I've crossed... I've been across here. This is a shrine here. I may as well do it. How many arrows do I have? 56. Alright, we're fine. Yahaha! I'm saving. that's safe to go here. I think this is a case of, multi-arrows. There we go. Kutakar. Of course I wasn't worthy. Trail of fire in an ice area. Offer me a block of ice, only then will the passport open. Here's the thing about this one as well. I'm pretty sure the block is solid enough to survive. Hold on. Once it's high enough, then do that. Oh shit, it didn't work. I thought that would have been enough to launch it. If I had a Korok, like, I'd be able to make it work. Be able to push its trajectory along. Here. I wish you could control tilt on this. Ugh, you can't. It's a bit of a tall order, that one. But I think I can do this either way. Okay. I'm also gonna have more fun doing it this way than the intended way. Is it being weird? I mean, is it possible to just bypass this whole thing? I might not even need to put ice in it, period. Let's see. Looks like it has a roof. It has an anti-cheese roof. Every time I see the metallic block, I just want to cheese it with the balloon thing. Anyway, let's just do it normally. Done this a lot of times over. It's not that hard. I was just curious if I could do the balloon thing. Thank you. Hmm. Oops. Ooh, that's bad. Oh, crap. I fell back on my head. I messed it up. I don't know, I'm gonna keep trying to cheese it. I think if the way it works is if I latch it onto this, it gives it momentum in that direction. Okay. Hey, that worked. It worked. I shot so many arrows at it, that's why. Works for me. Could have been cleaner. One oh five. Okay, chat, it's time for an intermission. It's been 3 hours roughly, so I'm gonna take a short break. I'm gonna stretch my legs, get a beverage, and we'll continue. But if you're watching later on YouTube, this is the part where I say, bye YouTube, thanks for watching. And consider doing fun algorithm stuff if you want to support. But yeah, see you next time.